Hey everyone, Wyatt-Andrews-Workshop here, and welcome to the tree tier list. This is just a little something I wanted to put out there just for the sake of, you know, getting videos out, because I know it's been a little while. So, this just sort of came over me, because I have a lot of I'm very passionate about trees. I don't know. I really love the foliage in this game, especially compared to the previous installment, Planet Coaster. And I really love most of the trees, but I also really hate some of the others. So I just thought I would share my very useless and inconsequential opinion on which trees are the best and which trees are the worst. So I have all of the trees in the game pulled up here, and we'll just start from the top. And I might change my opinion on different ones halfway through. We'll just see how it goes. So, first, Australia fan palm number one. I'm gonna put it in A tier. That's a solid A tier. Really neat for like sort of tropical understory. And I'm also gonna put number two in here and number three. Yeah, I think that's good. They all sort of fulfill the same purpose. Number four, I'm gonna put in S tier, just because it's like a great sort of like terrarium filler, and also if you really want to get like more detailed with the sort of undergrowth of your sort of tropical map, this is the way to go. All right, and then acai palm number one. This is definitely on the larger side, not quite as useful, so I'm still gonna put it in B because it's definitely still like a pretty model. Same for number two, but then I'm gonna put number three in A tier just because I think it's much more versatile and you can like put it in like tropical houses and stuff like that. You can't really do it with these two just because they're much taller. All right, then the banana trees, banana palms, I should say. I think number one is A tier. It's got some nice volume to it, but then two and three are probably in the C tier, just because they're a little like pointier, and there's not a whole lot I can do with them. Actually, I'm gonna put number one in B tier, just because like they're a little too green for my liking. I like sort of much warmer shades of green like this. That's just my personal taste. Again, this is all personal taste. You can totally disagree with me on all of this. So next is baobab trees, D tier. I don't like the baobabs in this game. I have no use for them. They are massive. They are too orange, and we should have a not like a dead version, just because zoos use those way more than like sculpting like a live baobab tree from scratch. The only time I've seen them used well is in Tivoli Zoo with Ruble's baobab experience. Yeah, that's pretty much the only time. Use Leaf's or Vihoa's, I don't know if he put that on the workshop, use Leaf's custom faux baobab tree, because it is much better and it does not have these giant, broad, ugly leaves. Alright, next, ooh, here we go, beech trees. Beech sapling, S tier. This is a god tier tree, just because if you sink it in the ground, look how good that looks. It's a perfect bush. And it also looks good not sunken into the ground. It is perfect, and I love it with all of my heart. If there was an S plus tier, this is where it would go. Beech tree number one, I'm gonna put in A tier, just because its leaves are like a little too big and sort of spaced out, but it's still a beech tree, so I still love it. Beech trees two and three, yeah, beech trees two and three are in S tier, because like, look how big that is. That is glorious. You can use that for anything to like fill in space. Like if you have like a huge corner of your zoo, but you don't really want to build anything, just fill it with beech tree number three and it will be filled in seconds. It is a beautiful tree. It has so many fluffy leaves. I want to hold it. I love it. All right, moving on to the black poplar trees. I think black poplar, all of them are a solid A tier. Number one, number three, and number four. Four? Actually, no. I don't really like number three. I think its trunk is a little too thick despite the size of the tree. That's why I like number four more, just because it's big but has like a really nice thin trunk. And then number one is also A tier, just because again, it's a great space filler, just like the larger beech trees. But then number two is going to be an S tier, just because like it's a that's what I think of when I think poplar, just like a really nice, almost sort of spiky looking tree that's great for like North American maps. All right, black spruce trees are going. I used to use black spruce trees all the time, but then I kind of sort of sharpened my color theory skills, and these guys kind of fell by the wayside as a result, just because I think they're a little too blue. We need like a dark, really dark conifer, like a sort of dark but still kind of warm green. These guys don't really do it for me. I'm gonna put this one in B, and then I'm actually gonna put this one, because I still this one is really nice because you can sink it down and it has like a really nice sort of weedy conifer that you can sort of use for ground cover. So here's what we're gonna do, because I'm still not a huge fan of all of them, so we're gonna put 2 and 3 in B, and then we're gonna put number 1 in C. That's our first C tier tree. All right, Brazil nut sapling. Most of the saplings are S tier, to be honest, because like they're so useful, especially this guy. Like if the beech sapling makes for a great bush, this guy makes for like great weeds, because like look at that, it's so like wiry and stringy, you can use it for like the perfect ground cover. So that's an S tier tree. And then Brazil nuts 1, 2. I don't want to attach it to any building. Brazil nuts 1, 2, and 3 are all S tier, because like the beech tree, they're massive, but they're also super gnarly. So you can like use them as like oaks if you don't want to use the actual oaks, which I usually don't because their leaves are too big. And before the eucalyptuses came out, I used these as eucalyptuses. They're just super versatile and more people should use them. And if you do want to use them, I recommend sinking them down almost all the way, just because like unless you're using them for Brazil nut trees, there's like no tree in North America or Europe that looks like this. But then when you sink it down, like that's like a canyon live oak. It's perfect. It's beautiful. S tier. Okay. Next, I'm losing my breath because I'm getting flustered over trees. Cherry blossom, broken cherry blossom to be specific. I used to use these all the time when I was like making like climbing structures out of these. But nowadays, not so much. They're like a little too dark brown and natural looking. I want like a dead tree that's been like shaved down and like meant for animals to use, you know? But I think this still gets the job done if you feel like it. But then like the Australia pack and the aquatic pack came out, and I'll show you what I mean. Okay, here we go. So as you probably noticed throughout all of my builds, this is what I use for climbing structures. Now pretty much almost entirely I just use the beams, and then I use these Australian logs as a base, and then I just attach the faux branches to them, which were for the aquatic pack and the Australia pack respectively. So yeah, download that on the workshop if you haven't already. I'm really proud of how those came out, and probably stop using this because it doesn't look extremely good. Moving on to the other broken cherry blossoms, I have even less use for these, so I'm going to put these in, what's this one? D tier. D tier is a little too harsh. They aren't bad, but they aren't very useful either. So we're going to put 2 and 3 in D tier. Oh, missed that one. There we go. Broken Himalayan pine. You know, not bad. I'm kind of impartial to most of the broken trees. Yeah, so these are probably B tier, all of them. I have like very little use for the stumps, but I guess, you know, they're useful if you're trying to make like some more like lived in ground cover. They're a little too like wiry, I guess is the right word. They have like a lot of tiny branches sticking out, but they aren't bad at all. Broken Scots pines, on the other hand, I think are much better. They're like much cleaner. Even though like they're a little hairy, but they're still cleaner than the Himalayan pines, and they have like that nice red color that all of the Scots pines have. I'm just gonna put the stump in the lower tier just because I never really use the stumps. There we go. And then broken white birch tree number 1, or the just broken birch trees in general. I'm torn between A and B because they look really nice, but I'm probably just gonna stick them in B just because I use birch trees very rarely, so broken birch trees would be even less. And then the broken yellow ipe trees, that's definitely not how you say the ipe. It's probably like ipe or something, but I didn't look it up beforehand. I'll probably throw it up front for people who want to know. But I actually really like this guy. It's probably not an A tier, but I really like this stump. It's a nice stump. This is a less nice stump, but it's probably still in B tier with the others. Broken yellow ipe tree. Again, like I used to use the broken trees all the time before we got better resources for climbing structures, but I think this definitely still has utility if you're creative enough. Candelabra trees. This one I do not like. It is way too tall and it has a weird, funky angle that I do not like. Two, I'm gonna put in. Okay, so that one was C tier. This one is probably A tier, just because it's nice and straight, it has a nice solid canopy. Candelabra tree 3, I'm putting in S tier, because you can sink this guy down and get some amazing ground cover. Like, look at that. That's perfect. Use it for like moss, use it for whatever you want, but it'll look super good whatever you do. So that's S tier. Cecropia trees. Number one, I'm gonna put in A tier, just because it's not as good as two and three, but two and three I'm gonna put in S tier. Because like, look at that. They're amazing. They have such cool branches, they're extremely tall. You can flip them over and make like palm tree trunks out of them. They are very versatile. Hold on. Yeah, like look at that. That's perfect. Cherry blossom trees. Oh god. I know, I hate joy and fun and color and all that is good in the world. I'm putting these in F. I have no use for these and I never will because I am a joyless asshole who hates color. Moving on. mangrove trees, coastal mangrove trees. I'm gonna put this little guy in A tier just because this is great for like touch pools and stuff like that. You can just sink them down and then they don't like obstruct too much room. Two and three, I'm gonna put in B tier just because I think they're a little overused. Like I notice people like make a pond for like a hippo or a Nile monitor and stuff like that, and they'll just throw these in, and it's like, no, that's not what mangrove trees are for. They're coastal, they are in the ocean, and yeah. And they're also just like a little too like warm in their green color for my liking, but they're not bad at all. And this guy is definitely better because this guy has much more use. Moving on to the coconut palms, I'm gonna put this guy in D tier just because I have very little use for it. But then I'm also gonna put this guy in D tier. I think coconut palm is a very overused tropical plant. But then coconut palms number, is this three? Yeah, coconut palm number three, I'm gonna put in B tier, and coconut number. Palm number four, I'm gonna put in A tier because these guys, actually no, I'm gonna put both in A tier because these guys make for great custom palm trees if you just put like an African, the African barrel, you just stack it up like a million times and then you put this thing at the top and it looks great. I use these all the time for my Griffith Zoo, for my LA Zoo recreation. They make for like a great custom palm tree, but on their own they aren't like perfect, but they're nice and straight and still better than those two. Okay, ash tree. Ooh, mama. These are probably my favorite tree in the game because they're so thick and bushy, and you can use them anywhere, and you can just stack them up, and they make for such like great, just green wall nests. They're perfect. S tier tree. S plus if I had that. Corkwood tree. I have probably put these down like less than five times. They're very generic. They have like an ugly, desaturated, like soft green. But they aren't bad at all. But I never use them personally. I'm just gonna toss them in the raw C tier. Okay, custard apple tree. Not great. They're their leaves are way too big, and you could just use the ash tree or the beech sapling if you want like that scattered green ground cover. What is this tier? This is D tier. I think this is where these guys belong. I used to use them all the time, not anymore. Moving on to the cypress trees. I think cypress trees are another solid A tier tree. I don't use them too often, but when I do, they look amazing. They're very useful for nailing down that like Tuscany vibe. Or if you just like want to do anything sort of classical, these guys are your go-to. The Dahurian larch tree, F. I don't like orange pine tree. It is bad. I've never seen them used well. Maybe they look cool in real life, but in exhibits, they do not work for me at all. Okay, date palm. I used to use date palms all the time, but then I started using my custom coconut palms, and these guys have kind of fallen by the wayside, to be honest. Their sort of texture isn't great. Like the leaves are way too like angular. It's like duh, 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 when it should be like a much sort of smoother curve, but they aren't bad. I have some nostalgia for them, so I'm gonna put them all in B tier. They also don't make for very bad custom trees either. The desert bloodwood tree. I've really come around to these guys. I used to hate their like excessively red bark, but if you're trying to make like an arid style zoo or place in general, these guys are great. They have really nice gnarly trunks, and I actually really like the flowers. They're very understated and not too like aggressive like they are on something like the tamarind tree. All right, speaking of desert trees, we have the desert ironwood. I don't use these guys too often. I'm a little taken aback by the sort of pinkness of them, but if you want like a nice understated pink looks over at cherry blossom tree, these guys are the way to go. I'm gonna put these all in solid B tier. We're kind of blazing through these. Douglas fir pine. I'm torn between A and S tier because these guys are definitely like the best generic pine tree in the game, but I don't have like too much love for them. I couldn't gush over these guys 24/7 like I could the S tier trees, but they are very solid. Elm trees. They're okay. I don't like how warm they are. They're like practically yellow, but I think these guys are good in B tier. Because they have really, really cool trunks. Like, look at that. That's awesome. But I don't use these guys too often. Never used them like on my own project, but in collabs, I never like feel the need to tear them down. You know, they're solid. Festive spruce. Who doesn't love a good Christmas tree, huh? I really love these guys. We've had two holiday seasons with them now, and I've scattered them all over the place every time. I think 1 and 2 are S tier, and then 3 might be A tier, just because it's like a little too large for my liking. But, you know, it's the same model, so you can't really go too far down. Alright, foxtail palm. I don't like this one. I would only use this if I was building an In-N-Out. But, you know, it's not a bad model at all. The foxtail palm model in general is gorgeous. Like, look how fluffy those fronds are. Compare that to the date palm, and you'll see what I mean when I don't really like the date palm all that much. So we're gonna put these guys in A tier. There you go. Ghost gum sapling. This is probably my least favorite sapling, just because I never really feel the need to put down a eucalyptus sapling. Like, it's cool, but I don't know, and I don't really have much use for it. I'm gonna throw that in B tier, but then I'm gonna put the other ghost gums in A tier, just because I think the white is overwhelming to say the least. But if you're ever doing like a California or a eucalyptus or an Australia themed area, these guys are insanely cool. Like, look at that. That almost looks real. I love the way the light reflects off their trunks. They have that kind of wrinkled texture. They nailed that from tier. Giant red cedars. Again, I think another solid A tree. I'm actually gonna put 1 and 2 in A, and then, or 1 and 3 in A, and then 2 in S, just because I really love how like skinny it is. Like, if you're building like a big conifer forest and you're like running out of, or like you have like a like little like slivers you want to fill, these guys work great. Himalayan birch trees. These guys, they're okay. They're like a little too gnarly compared to like the normal birch trees. I'm probably gonna put them in C tier. I would only ever use these if I was building like a sort of mountainous area. Speaking of mountainous trees, we have the Himalayan pine. Not a fan. The only way these guys work for me is if I, watch this, is if I take them and then I just spin them around. Because otherwise, like the Himalayan birch, they are way too gnarly and weedy for my liking. So all of those guys are going to go in C tier with their brothers, the Himalayan birches. And then holly trees. Never ever use these. These guys are with the corkwoods, trees that I just never use. Yeah, C tier. Don't look bad, but not very practical. The hookthorn acacia, though, is slightly more practical. I think this is a solid B tier tree, just because like the green is a little too cool, especially for savannas. Like, when I see somebody put this in their savanna exhibit, it kind of just blows it for me, just because like it's supposed to be like very warm and arid, and then you just get this like bright, cool aquamarine tree, and it doesn't really work for me. But I think these guys' like main strength is as a ground cover, because like look at that, that's great. They're like little ferns almost with the leaf shape. All right, now to funnel my rage into another colorful tree. Here we go, the Japanese maple. Ugh. It looks like it's on fire. I hate it. Never in my life would I ever... Can we get a naked version of these guys? They have very cool trunks. Like, look at how gnarly they are. That's neat. Make it naked. Strip the tree naked, please. Then I will tolerate it. Joshua tree. I used to use these guys all the time before the Triodia grass came out, because, like, as you can see, they're very similar in texture, but then they have like the little flower in the middle, and it's not great, but it's definitely a very gorgeous model. So I'm gonna put them in B tier, just for that. Kapok trees, oh boy. every tree I dislike, I probably used to use all the time, and this is no exception. These are our first E tier trees, just because they are everything the Brazil nut, or they're everything the Brazil nut is, or they're supposed to be. These guys wish they were the Brazil nut, is what I'm trying to say. Because, like, let me grab the Brazil nut. There we go. Like, the Brazil nut, it has, like, so many leaves. It has this gorgeous, gnarly trunk. Then you move over to the Kapok, and it's like really weird and angular, and the leaves are too big, and they're really shiny for some reason. And whenever I see these, they just sort of make me sad. They're not great. These are our first E-tier trees. They do have a really nice like root system though, but like, you're never gonna put down a tree this tall unless you're building the Amazon rainforest from scratch. So let me find them. E-tier. No good. All right. I keep attaching these to the buildings. Hold on. Lipstick palm is up next. These guys are really cool. I haven't really had the chance to apply them that much, and I'm not a huge fan of their like bright red trunks, but they aren't bad. I've seen people do a really good job with them. So we'll probably put them in B tier. I hope to use them someday, but for now, I will just respect them from a distance. That is really cool. See, now I'm like making discoveries. Okay, mangrove apple. Gross. Don't like the mangrove apple. It's like the corkwood tree. It has the same color. It's just like that straight up green. No warm, no cool, just green. And like the canopy, or not the canopy, the trunk is like, has the same issue as the Kapok. It's too gnarly, you know? There's no curvature to it. It's just jagged. That's definitely the word for these guys, is jagged. They are a very unprofessional tree. Marula trees, on the other hand, are my perfect trees. These guys are so good if you want like a brown, warm tree to just fill out space. They're like the ash tree. They have super thick leaves, and you can put them everywhere, even though they're African, but they look good anywhere. and you can just bunch them up, and they look perfect if you want, like a warmer alternative to the ash tree. That's how I best describe them. And the monkey puzzle tree, they're okay. A little too cool. I feel like monkey puzzle trees are a lot darker and warmer than this, but they're all right. I'll put them in B tier. Don't really have much use for them. Maybe someday. Oak sapling, S tier. This guy's phenomenal. Same as the Brazil nut sapling. You can just sink these guys down and they make such great weedy ground cover. But then as they grow older, you get oak tree 1, 2, 3, and 4, and they're not great. They have really cool trunks, but the leaves are way too big. Like, look how big those are. They just spread out and they're not like appealing at all. But I used to use them all the time, and they're still better than things like the mangrove apple and the coconut palm and the baobab trees. I'm gonna put all of these guys in C tier, except oak tree number 3, because oak tree number 3 has like a really nice thin trunk, and you can get some really nice like cover with this one. We're gonna extend the B tier because we're running out of room. There we go. So oak tree number 3, dunk on your brothers because you are better than them. Same with oak tree 4. Let's find that real quick. Oak tree 4 is just too big, man. That's too much, man. All right, ombu trees. I think ombu trees are a solid A tier. I use them whenever I need like a really thick canopy that just covers everything. But other than that, they really have no other practical application. But they are really nice, so I'm gonna put them in A tier just because they have that one flaw. Then we're gonna extend the A tier because the ombus are so massive that they cover the whole thing. Then we'll move on to the next one, which is the polylepis tree. These guys are okay. B tier. They have nice fluffy canopies, but I use them very rarely. They're like worse. They're like a hybrid between the frankincense tree and the manzanita tree. They have the same texture as the frankincense trunk, but then they have very similar canopies to the manzanita. Ponderosa pine. I'm very torn between A and S on this one because I use them everywhere, but they aren't the best looking, to be honest. I think we're just gonna put them in A because they look very, very nice as like an either a desert tree or a temperate tree. You can use these guys just about anywhere if you're setting your zoo in the US. And then the ponytail palms. I disliked these at first. I thought their trunks were very goofy. But then when you sink them down, this is what you gotta do if you really wanna test the merit of a foliage item. You gotta sink it down and see if it's good if you don't like it at first. Because look how good that looks. If you want like raw, straight up tropical ground cover or swampy ground cover, these guys are the way to go. And we're gonna sink them down just to pretend the trunks don't exist, because now they're S tier. All right, the poya plant. This one is S tier, just because it doesn't have this massive like bloom in the middle, which doesn't look bad by any means, but it sort of automatically makes it lesser if you're doing some sort of normal gardening. So we're gonna put the other poyas in B tier. There you guys go. All right, I think we're over halfway. Quaking aspen. These guys are gorgeous. If only they weren't yellow. So we're gonna put them in C just because they're yellow. If you wanna use them for a fall map, they're perfect. They would be S tier if you're making a fall map. But otherwise, I have no use for these. Moving on to the rainbow eucalyptus. I think number 1 is an S tier, just because it's got like a nice thin trunk. It's got like a really pretty canopy, especially when the light hits it. Look how pretty that is. But then its friends, I'm gonna put number 2 in A, just because it has the same qualities as number 1, but its trunk is a little too thick for me. And then we're gonna put, oh great, we just duplicated all the plants. Hold on. Technical difficulties. we're gonna put number three in B tier just because it's a little too chunky. It has that gnarly root system, which would be great if I were doing like a rainbow eucalyptus forest, but otherwise it doesn't really have a practical application. River bush willow, yay, I love it. It's so colorful. I love colorful things, as you can tell. Not great. Maybe not F, just because they have really nice leaves, but otherwise, that's too much, man. Too much orange. Oh, right from D tier to S plus tier, we got the Scots pine. Ooh, mama. These guys are beautiful. They're so good. I use Scots pines in everything I've ever built. They are perfect. They're the perfect gnarly conifer. They have such nice red trunks, but it doesn't overstay its welcome. Especially this guy. I would put this guy in S++ if it existed, because like look how gnarly that is. And you can make some like great custom trees with these guys if you want to like smash them together. You can get some really nice combinations. Alright, the soap tree yucca. These guys are like the poya plant, but worse. We're gonna do probably, I think this is D tier? Yeah. Soap tree yucca goes in D tier. Not a huge fan of this guy. Give me the soap tree yucca. Come back. Soap tree yucca. They look good for a desert garden, but otherwise, they're a little too cold. They're like a hybrid of the Joshua tree and the poya plant, but taking the worst qualities of both of those. Alright, this counts as a tree apparently, but it's not a bad one. We're gonna put this guy, the South American mossy tree, in A tier, because it's a really nice log. For doing anything tropical, I constantly have to expand these. I should have just made them bigger from the start. Okay. Strangler fig root edge. Do these even count? If they did, they wouldn't be very good. We're just gonna move past those. Those do not count. But they're bigger brothers, the strangler figs. They're okay, I guess. I've used this one. This one is much better. We're gonna put this one in SAB. We're gonna put this one in B tier. Then we're gonna put his friends in D or C. I'm gonna put it in D tier. I have literally no use for these. If I was like making like a very heavily themed tropical area, maybe like something like Suyanazu, but otherwise not great. And then back to S tier for the S starting with S. Where are they? Stringy wood eucalyptus. This guy is an S tier tree. Look at that. Look at that effing canopy. Oh, it's so pretty. It's so like wide and gnarly and beautiful. It's perfect. It's a perfect tree. This guy is also perfect, but slightly less perfect. This would be an S, this would be an S+. But then this guy, he doesn't really pick up the slack compared to his brothers. It's a little too chunky, but still an A tier. Sudanese frankincense tree, S. Perfect, desert gnarly tree. You can spin it around, make some perfect, beautiful desert trees. Or just any tree, really. Like, it goes anywhere, even though it's a desert one. That's an S tier tree, baby. Moving on. Let's see what's next. We're almost there. Sugar maple tree. Another orange guy. Oh boy. You guys know how much I love color. Be gone with you. To the devil with you. Alright, next we have sugar maple trees. These guys are, they're the epitome of okay, you know? They're not bad, not great. Like, their leaves are like a little too crusty, if that makes sense. Like, the way the light bounces off of them, it's like very, like, form heavy. compared to something like, let's find a good example. Compared to something like the marula tree, which is just perfect in my opinion. Okay, and then, or perfect in like the sense that like the lighting is much more consistent, whereas the sycamores are like light here, shadow here, light here, shadow here. It's just a little too heavy in the contrast. The tamarind tree. Now, when I mentioned the bloodwood, I liked how the flowers were nice and understated. This has the opposite problem, or the